So hello, a very good morning to one and all. We welcome you to MIT ID workshop series. Since last 4 years, as a part of Design Connect program, we are interacting with students through various seminars and webinars where experts from industry share their experience with young budding designers. This year, we have moved one step ahead where we are engaging the design aspirants in the activity. The student will actually participate in the workshop and get hands-on experience on various topics and areas of design. There's an announcement for the students. All the participants will get a certificate, and top 3 submissions will receive a special certificate and mention on our social media platform. So don't forget to upload your work along with your photograph right after the workshop. Today, we have with us Professor Amit Deshmukh, who heads the Interior Space and Furniture Design at MIT Institute of Design. Sir has done his bachelor's in architecture and from Pune and master's in industrial design from SPA, New Delhi. He has joined MITID after an experience from all forms of the design profession. His work includes a work in industry, a work under Institute NID, and the professional sector of the design field. At MIT Institute of Design, Amit sir is engaged with interior space and furniture design, product design, and foundation discipline. As a faculty, his core area includes space and form studies, nature-inspired design, systems design, molded furniture, structures of geometry, also an interest in research activities and a learning attitude brings him in education field. Apart from teaching, sir has contributed in setting up of MITID as well. Now, I request Professor Amit Deshmukh sir to take over the further proceedings of the workshop.
Okay, good morning. Good morning all of you and welcome to this workshop. I'm Professor Amit Deshmukh. And as you know, first of all, welcome to this workshop. Welcome to all for registering to this workshop. I hope we'll have a very exciting time for 1.5 hours next, where, as the name suggests, we'll look at Kissa Kursi Ka, a story of a chair. Okay. So through this, we are looking at how an object can be put forward as an expression, as a design expression. Okay, so it's not a workshop of designing a chair, okay, but definitely it's very much enjoyable as we'll go through very stepwise processes to achieve our results. Now, before going to that, a quick overview of who we are and just about the design field. So, welcome. This is the right time for all of you to get into design as a career, because overall the profession also is in very much demand of design professionals. So we are at MIT Institute of Design, have been into this design education for last around 13 years, and over here we are looking at the kind of verticals that we have is, we have industrial design, we have communication design, and we have fashion design as 3 verticals. And within that, we have 12 plus disciplines that we offer education at. So there are around 1200 plus design students. We have 12 BDES programs, 14 MDES programs. We have a PhD program, and it's a huge campus that we have. And just moving ahead, a glance what MIT students are doing. So different kind of projects that students are into: transportation design, fashion, product, furniture, graphics, animation, film and video. And these are kind of industry partners that we have. Okay, so our admission processes, as you all know, have already started. Okay, now starting with the workshop, these things, what is design? So just giving an overview of the things. So design inspirations basically come from different fields. So sociology, geography, culture, art, literature, science, technology, and history. Okay. So nature of design is, design starts with unknown, Design creates alternatives. Design thinking is basically design doing, and that's what we believe into in terms of our philosophy. Design is multidisciplinary, and design addresses emotions. So who can be a designer? Anybody who has an ability to empathize, ability to frame problems, love of arts and culture, ability to constantly think and be different, and ability to marry science and art. Those are basic qualities that a design learner should have. So what are we looking at today? So we are looking at, from all these things, ability to empathize, ability to constantly think to be different, so be creative in certain way, and we'll also address the emotional aspect of design, so how certain emotions can be transferred in terms of tangibles in design. Okay, so let's begin with our workshop, Kissa Kursi Ka, a story of a chair. Okay, now what defines a chair? Is it anything that you sit on, or is it something or anything can be used as a chair? So chair design in particular is considered as a very complex process, but of course it's most exciting of all, and many architects and designers have expressed their design philosophies through designing of a chair. So a chair design basically puts you into test in various aspects. So why such a complex thing we as a design aspirants are attempting? So the workshop will give you a glimpse at design process that goes behind designing of an object like a chair. It's an attempt to understand design process as an expression. That's what we are concentrating on. Design of an object happens within a context. So we'll try to understand that context and how that context can be translated into a design, and it becomes a symbol of qualities it is designed for. The workshop is aimed at design aspirants, giving them opportunity to develop their portfolio. So whatever the outcome of this workshop will be, can go directly into your portfolios and will be helpful for you for all the entrance tests and interviews, whichever you will appear for. Okay, so we'll learn to extract a context from a user through a mini questionnaire that we'll go through. How to translate user insights into design tangibles that will express user qualities. How to compose design elements into third dimension. So how to put all these things together, that we'll look at. We'll also look at conceptualization and visualization of design ideas, and how to present your ideas. So sketching as an expression is also what we'll use that. Okay, now let's start with the actual this thing. Let's start with this exciting journey. So I'll be putting forward few questions, and within your mind, since we are not interacting physically, within your mind you just answer these questions wherever you are. So what is a chair? What defines a chair? Or what comes in your mind the moment you think of a chair? Is it something which is this? A very typical plastic chair that you see everywhere, or a different version of the same chair, which also can be seen everywhere? Okay, or is it this, a very typical chair from the memories, maybe a chair of earlier generation? Okay, a chair which is kind of an expression of the kind of craft which goes on it, or very radical expressions like this. So the first question that would come to my mind, is this a chair? Yeah, these are chairs designed by very famous designers, of course. So going to the next basic question, what defines a chair? So is it just the surface that you sit on to? Is it that the height that you sit on to? What defines a chair? So is it its parts? So if you look at these things, the different parts that a typical chair will have, is that what defines a chair? Or is it the space where the chair is placed? So the earlier plastic chair that we looked at, if it is kept in different kind of space context, it will be perceived in a different way. So does space plays a very important role in terms of defining a chair? Or is it for whom the chair is designed for? For example, if it's as a screen shows different images, is it somebody who's very adventurous, a air hostess in terms of professional, a cricketer, a teacher, a police officer, a businessman, a politician, okay, a cook, an ordinary worker, okay, or even a postman. So do these personalities define the chair? Does chair has a personality? Or does it reflect a personality? So I have few images over here, again chairs designed by famous designers. So does chair is seen as an expression? And can we reverse it in a way? Looking at a chair, what kind of person will sit on this chair? The images definitely will follow. So who do you think will sit on something like this? It's a very famous movie from which this chair is, or chair or throne, whatever we call it as, or a very simple kind of a sitting arrangement will define the person's quality through the elements that are around over here. So we often read about stories of struggle of power in present as well as in history. A chair or a throne is what the struggle is for. A chair thus becomes an emblem of authority, power, and dynasty. As a ruler of the throne will always tint that object by his virtues or his qualities. A famous image from the famous TV series, web series. So how do designers design chairs? Can we take a glimpse of it? So again, through this workshop, we are definitely not going into designing a chair, because it's a very complex process as we looked at. So what we are going to look at is chair as an expression. So can we take a glimpse of it? So let's start from ourselves. This is where the brief of the workshop now will be there on your screen. Okay, let's start from ourselves. So let's imagine that you are higher of a throne and are about to become a king or a queen of a big kingdom, something like that. So what sort of throne would you like to sit upon? What message your throne should give about you? So is it that you're good or you're evil? Does your throne should show your authority? Does your throne should show that you are compassionate, or maybe you are very cruel? Does the throne should show your wealth that you have as a king or a queen? And what height you would like to sit at? So at a very basic ground level, sitting in a very Indian kind of a posture, a normal chair height, or to give your authority at a very elevated level you would like to sit at? And what material you would like your throne to be of? Will it be wood? Will it be a very radical material like ice? Or would it be a stone throne that you would like to sit on? So these are the questions which I would like you to just give your answers to. Okay, so just think about it, take a blank sheet of paper and write about what kind of throne you would like to sit on. Okay, so whatever the further slides that will go through, it's a mini questionnaire that we'll go through, and you as a participant would have to answer these questions. Just write it on any blank sheet of paper. Okay, and these are the words which we are going to take forward and design a throne for ourselves. Okay, so let's start with the questionnaire. Okay, so since we are designing the throne for ourselves, let's describe ourselves. Okay, so are we, let's describe ourselves in terms of who we are. So, am I tall or short? Am I thin or I'm plump? Okay. What shape face do I have? Do I have a square face? Do I have a round face? Do I have a triangular face? Oblong face? Oval? Diamond shape? Or a heart shaped face? How do you perceive yourself as? Now, this is about our personality. Now, looking at our qualities as a king or a queen. So, would you like to portray yourself as a good king or a queen, or an evil king or a queen? We can attempt both over here. Okay. So, the moment we have taken a decision onto this, my throne should show that I am very modest or very arrogant. I am with a very pleasant personality, or I want to portray myself as a pleasant personality, or I want to show my harshness through my throne. I would be a very generous king or a queen, or I would be very selfish, and those qualities would be shown through my throne. I would be a very compassionate as a ruler, or I'll be very cruel. I hope you are noting down these things the way we are proceeding. Okay, these are very general basic questions. Definitely you can add more qualities into it. Now the main question comes is, with these inputs, can we derive the tangibles for our expression? Okay, and how do we do that? Okay, so once these qualities have been listed out, we'll definitely look at finding inspirations for these qualities. Okay, so the easiest one that definitely would go for is find out symbols or icons for all the attributes that you have selected. Okay, so if you have mentioned that you are compassionate, what kind of symbol or what kind of icon would portray that you are compassionate? If you have selected that you are cruel, what kind of symbols, what kind of icons would portray that you are very cruel? Okay, so these are the kind of things that we'll look into. I have a few samples. I'll just show you over here. So something like this, very randomly, we can just quickly pick certain icons. The icons also can be very culturally selected, that if you decide that, okay, I am a king in India, or I am a king of some fantasy kind of a land somewhere else. So, how culturally those icons would be taken, okay? Or if I am a very evil kind of a magician, so can magic related icons be selected in that way, okay? Yeah, so with this mini questionnaire and this introduction, I think I'll just give you some time to look through these things, okay? And definitely as the workshop progresses, I'll keep on interacting. I'll be here. I'll also work parallelly with you, and we'll be interacting with you with stepwise based on whatever kind of inputs that you have come across with or you have extracted from yourself. In between, if you have any doubt, just raise your hand, type the questions, so that those queries can be addressed. We'll try to address as many queries as possible through this. And this is how we are going to progress through that. So I'll just give you some time to kind of find out these icons, just internalize onto this mini questionnaire, and just think about the qualities. Okay. In the meantime, what I will do is I'll quickly run back through the presentation. Okay, and going through these questionnaires again, okay, and which will kind of give you again a glimpse of what kind of throne you would like to have. Okay, so going back to the presentation, would you like to portray yourself as a good king, queen, or an evil king or a queen? Okay, How would you like to put your authority or symbolize your authority? So the way in these images, it's shown that a lion is holding the entire world underneath his feet. Okay, so that kind of a thing. Or just by making everybody look up to you, those are the kind of very symbolic ways through which this authority can be put forward. Compassion, cruelness, these kind of qualities can very nicely be portrayed through the color palette that one can look at or through the materials that can be used. Using materials which will show your wealth, okay, something like gold, a very intricate kind of a carving, using or seeing materials in that way, using the precious stones on your throne, which shows your wealth, or certain icons which also symbolize the wealth. Okay, this decision is very essential for you to take, at what height you would like yourself to sit on to. So, for example, a very compassionate king who empathizes with the people around him would not like to show his authority by sitting at a very high this thing. Or the way the third image from a very famous movie shows that he is at a very elevated level, unreachable, and shows his authority and power in that way. Material definitely would play an important role. It's not necessary that the chair has to be completely into one material. It can be a combination of different materials, but a material also can be used as an expression. Okay, in earlier images, the way we saw that gold is used as an expression of wealth. So even for expressing modesty, okay, certain qualities of like that, we can also look at it in that way. Okay, and describing ourselves. So whether these are the qualities which will help you put your chair. So it will kind of customize the expression for yourself. So these are some questions about yourself. You can definitely add more to this, okay, in terms of describing yourself. Okay, so what kind of face do I have? Okay, what is my body type? And definitely coming back to the fact that what is the message that you want to portray to the chair? You are a good king or a queen, or you are an evil king or a queen. You can choose anyone. Okay. So these are few kind of attributes that we have just listed over here. You can again definitely add on to more of these attributes which you feel you are. Okay. So again, where we had kind of relooked at the entire process, finding out symbols which would depict the attributes that you have selected. Okay, so now going back to the presentation, so once these icons are kind of identified, what are the elements of a typical throne that you would like to have in your throne? Okay, so again, I have these few images which would give you an idea. So would my throne like to have some animal icons? Animals which will depict my qualities. Okay, so animals which will depict aggression, animals which will depict modesty, these kind of qualities. Animals which will depict my compassion towards my people, okay, again, the back. So can it be a huge back that is there and it shows my authority in certain ways? Or would I like to go very futuristic, but I would like to see for the comfort for myself. So would my throne would have some cushion? Okay, would I like to have a footrest, okay, wherein the kind of posture I am sitting onto my chair is the way I am putting it forward into? And would I like to have my armrest? So again, it goes back to the posture in which I am sitting onto. So again, these are the things that we have to kind of tick mark and we have to go with. And this is where, once this mini questionnaire is kind of answered, we'll go back to putting all our findings together. Okay, so if you have looked at the earlier communication that we have made with you, okay, we have shown this template on the screen. Now you can see that this was the template which was shared with you. Okay, so if it is possible for you to take a printout of this template, that will be very helpful, because the idea of the workshop is not to learn sketching. The idea of the workshop is not to design a chair again. Okay, the idea of the workshop is not to look at how good you are able to draw a chair. Okay, so that is why this template, which is in your screen right now, is there, which will show you that, which will help you in terms of sketching onto it. So you can just take a printout of this template and sketch onto it. If printing this template at the moment is not possible, or it's not happening right now, you can keep, I'll keep this screen on too. You can keep looking at this and you can also sketch on this template like that. And while we are going through this, I'll also work simultaneously on the same brief. So I'll be working on paper, I'll be sketching along with you. And I'll also demonstrate how certain things can be extracted. Okay, again, to be very keeping myself again aligned with the objective of the workshop, we are not looking at, this is not a sketching exercise. So we are not looking at how well you can sketch, but it's whether you are able to express these qualities through finding these icons and just going through this process that we have described over here. Okay, so whom should I design the throne for? Okay, so again, going on to the screen, I'll design it for Lord Voldemort, a very famous personality from the Harry Potter series. And I'll just imagine that he's sitting onto a throne, or if at all he is sitting onto a throne, what kind of throne he would prefer it for? Okay, so we know definitely he's not a good king or a queen. And what are the qualities that he has? Okay, so he is very ruthless. He lacks ability to love. He doesn't empathize at all. Okay, and he's very cold. He's somebody who will always show that he is very powerful. He is very intelligent, definitely yes. He is very extreme and he is very dominant. But he also fears death. Maybe that's the reason, that's the kind of interpretation that many people have of him. And these are the few icons that one can extract. So the Death Eater mark, the Slytherin house, the Nagini, both the serpent definitely would express his qualities. Okay, his ideologies in terms of crushing the other people, okay, which is expressed through the thought that magic is might, okay, is expressed through that kind of a sculpture. It is also there in the movie. Definitely we can take something from that. And the kind of setting that his throne would be into, so a very dark kind of environment, color palette that is there on the screen shows how that would be. And definitely a hint of his Horcruxes. Okay, so those are the elements that we would like to get things from. And now, of course, I think I'll also start with the sketching part. Okay, so yeah, so this is the template that you have. Even if you don't have the template, even if you don't have the template with you, that's fine. And we'll just start sketching onto this. Okay, so let's take these few elements that we have. Okay, so the first and foremost is the serpent. Okay, so let's see if we can extract something from the serpent. Okay, so just again, it's not a sketching exercise, so don't worry about how your sketches would come. Okay, we are not to be much worried about those factors at the moment, but just catching those qualities is very important. Okay, so a very aggressive kind of a posture of the serpent is what we are definitely looking at. Okay, so just quickly trying to get a kind of a essence of the serpent. Okay, so definitely these eyes would matter, the aggressive stance would matter. Okay, and whatever his body is, okay, that kind of a thing, that also would matter. We are definitely not looking at putting these things directly onto these chairs. Okay, so we'll see how I won't call it as an abstraction, okay, but the way these things will be transferred onto. Okay, so this is where we are looking at how these inspirations would get transferred onto these things. So the next icon that definitely would matter is the Death Eater mark. Okay, so just again getting a glimpse of it. Okay, not maybe copying it completely the way it is, but just a very sketchy form. Okay, in terms of that, okay, this has to be there, this has to be there. Okay, now somewhere we can also have the expression that, so there is one surface over here, there is another surface. Okay, and people are getting crushed underneath it. Okay, so all these kind of the human, the Muggle images that he has. Okay, so this also can get transferred onto this thing. So this is something that would like to extract. Okay, the next icon that would try to look at is he calls himself a lord. So he's very fond with his kind of a aristocratic background that he has. So he's very proud of being a heir of a very well-known family, definitely in the magical world. Okay, so the chair can have those kind of icons. Okay, so just trying to put those things, something that would, so these are few conceptual kind of explorations that we'll do, and we'll do the final thing. We'll put all these things together somewhere over here. Okay, so maybe something that is towering. Okay, he has a very oblong face. So if you look at Lord Voldemort's face, he has a very oblong face. So can that kind of reflect somewhere over here in the high back? Okay, again, just a loud thinking that we are doing. Okay, and then this, when in design education we keep constantly stressing on to, we are using sketching as a tool for expressing our thinking. It's a thinking tool. Okay, it's not about making those pretty pictures. So are you able to put your thought through that? is what we are looking at. Now, he definitely would like to express his authority in that way. So, yes, the armrest would be there. And what is the best place to kind of put this thing over here? Okay, so we'll just try, like kind of explore how, what happens if the snake is kind of transferred over here, okay, as a hand rest. Obviously a very typical kind of expression, but let's just try it out at this moment. Okay, so both these hand rests would be like mouth of snakes. Okay, and definitely the snake would coil in, so it will go at the back. The eyes are very important, okay, and maybe it kind of coils in over here as well. Okay, so it goes back somewhere over there, and yeah, it can come back. As an expression, so these becomes my both the legs, maybe. Okay, that's one of the explorations that I have, and then I have something over here that would also come. Okay, now maybe I'm missing onto something. Okay, maybe again the cushion, because he is very selfish, so he would like himself to have a very cushiony kind of a background. Okay, so let's just put it, identify it in that way. Okay, that yeah, I have a soft surface over there, whatever way I have. Okay, so the emblem of the family, okay, the Slytherin, okay, the snake comes over here, cushions, okay, these form my leg. Okay, now what are the things that I'm missing out? Maybe the Dethita mark, okay, or yeah, this is a very important quality over here that we have. Okay, so showing his might and as a magician, so he looks down upon normal muggles. So maybe at the bottom I may try it in that way, that I'll put some icons. So let me put it as a different expression. Okay, and what happens if entire my shape of my chair is like a snake? Okay, or this is somewhere again that will have these. So again, I'm just trying to position this over here. Okay, so he's literally sitting on to the thing. So yes, he can have the elves, the muggles, the centaurs, those kind of people on all the sides. All these insights, how I'm getting, definitely after studying the personality. So that is where we are looking at a chair or a throne which is designed for yourself. So you can again hypothesize yourself to be a very evil person. Okay, you can even imagine yourself to be an Avenger or whatever way you would like to portray yourself as. Okay, but the idea is that how do I identify these things, how do I go about it, and how do I translate it onto an object. Okay, so now for this workshop, definitely we have taken chair as an object, but the same process, once you have gone through, can be applied to any kind of product. You can take a product and personalize it as per your qualities. It can be onto a vehicle, a object, It can be through a graphics wherein you are showing that, okay, through this graphic, this is the brand or this are the kind of graphical elements which represent myself. Okay, so the objective again of the workshop is to make you go through this entire process. Okay, coming back to that, so this is maybe the second expression that we have. Now, what am I missing out? Am I missing out anything from whatever we have discussed? Yeah, the Horcruxes. Okay. So maybe, yeah, understanding Lord Voldemort through the way he has been portrayed into, he definitely would not like, it's his secret, right? The Horcruxes are his secret. So we would not like to directly show that these things are, but it can give a glimpse of it. So maybe now this Death Eater mark, okay, can come somewhere over here. Okay, so yeah, this is where it would be. This is how the Death Eater mark can be there. Okay, the towering aristocratic kind of a colonial elements. To the chair also can go. Okay, yeah, and talking about the material, definitely, yes. The material of the chair would be wood, okay, on which these kind of cushions and these kind of emblems would be carved out. Okay, why that kind of a decision? Again, taking the cues from his personality only. He's very fond of collecting antiques or things which are very have a very important kind of a antiquitic value. Okay, so from that and the period that he is into, a wooden chair definitely would suffice. Again, the cushions will come, okay, maybe in some form or the other, and something which symbolizes the seven Horcruxes. Okay, so three on one side, three on other side. Of course, not a direct indication, but something which is very abstract. So these are the Horcruxes that would go over here. This is this emblem, Death Eater emblem, and then taking this down. Again, over here is where this kind of get carried. And armrest will follow the snake. So maybe the snake coils around again in that way. Okay, so now these are the kind of explorations that definitely we have. Now, what I was talking about is putting all these things together. Okay, so I have a kind of a bigger image over here. Even if you don't have this, that's fine. You can just draw it anyhow onto a blank sheet of paper. Okay, now few things that are missed onto from the questionnaire is, at what height would he like to sit onto? So would you like to have a footrest? Yes. So I'll tick on to that. So definitely he will have a podium. Okay. So maybe something like this. Okay. And something which indicates a footrest would also like to come in over here. Okay, so again, if you look at it, these are not very fine sketches. Okay, but that's not the objective. We are looking at how thinking can be put onto paper, okay, and how these things can be expressed in that way, okay. Now let's finalize few things and let's go according to that, okay, whatever way these things. So I think this is fine, the leg kind of a thing, okay. The idea of putting these over here is fine, okay. I'll also go with putting the hook cruxes, okay, and I'll also go with the footrest and these things, okay. Now what happens if these three things, whatever we have conceptualized, are put together? So now we'll again kind of put these three things together at a bigger scale and we'll try to visualize again how these things would go in, okay. So it's definitely a high back, so that is also what I'd like to go ahead with, the height. I'd also like to go ahead with these elements which are there, okay, and cushion of course, yes, so it might take any kind of shape in that way. So let's start with the snakes and try putting them over here, okay. So just carrying few things from the earlier ideas that we had, okay. So I'll go with the high back. I'll go with the oblong shape of the backrest. I'll go with the idea of putting the hook cruxes also on that. Okay. So the leg part of it, okay, maybe for back we can have some more snakes or those kind of icons coming from somewhere, okay, and I'll go with the Death Eater mark over here, okay, which is very characteristic. People fear with that, okay, so yeah, something that kind of put fears into people's. Okay, and I'll go with this idea of putting the icons of Muggles over here, okay, and of course a footrest. Okay, and a podium. So he'll always like his, or maybe a triangle, not the deathly hallows symbol, of course, but something that always will put the other people at a lower level. Okay, so yes, he is at an elevated level. Okay, and that is how his throne would be. Okay, now this is what we have arrived at. So let's just try to give it much more better and finalized form. Okay. So just kind of finalizing on to these forms. Again, if you notice, I am not giving much stress onto my sketching, but I'm just putting things which will give a very brief kind of idea of what my thought process is. And I just have to take a glimpse at how, when all these things are put together, would look. Putting few elements together, okay, and just kind of finalizing. Okay, or maybe this can come at the footrest as well. So, yeah, literally putting his foot and showing his evilness, or even it can come over here. Okay. So I hope you are also simultaneously doing that. Okay. So what we are doing is, once we finish off this workshop, we'll give you some time, and up till around 3 p.m. Okay, just upload whatever you have come up with. Okay. So you need to upload your work, maybe even a sketchy sheet like this, which kind of shows what kind of thought process you have been through. Okay, and of course we would need a photograph of you, because if you have to judge whether that personality, because definitely it's not possible to understand the qualities that are there, but maybe few through your facial features, we'll just try to see whether those kind of things are presented onto your expressions. Okay, so if it is possible to take a printout of this template, do it on that. You can finalize it. You can finalize it and you can upload it that way. Even a sketchy expression like this also would do. Okay. If you have any questions about whatever we have been through, just raise your hand. Raise your hand and just kind of you can ask these questions. So we could have that kind of an interaction over here itself. Okay, you can also put your questions into the chat box. So maybe not now, but later on also those could be answered. And it's a very quick process. It's a very spontaneous process that it has to do. Again, I'll keep emphasizing the fact that it's not a design project. Okay, so we are just looking at definitely. We are just looking at the way in which, as we said, how chair can be expressed or as an object can show the expressions, okay, of certain qualities, certain attributes that we have looked at. Okay, so very cautiously we have not used any colors, we have not used any textures. Okay, because those add on to different kind of complexities. Okay, so just to give you a glimpse again of certain things, that the design process is very user-centric. Okay, so as a design aspirant, you have to understand the user, and you should have an ability to empathize with him, to extract his qualities. Even good qualities, positive qualities, negative qualities, whatever it is, and those need to get reflected in your expression. Okay, so I would say in the entire design process, this is just a tip of the iceberg. It's not the entire design process at all. Definitely the objective of this workshop is not to take you through a design process, but basically as an expression. Okay, so that's what this thing particularly is. Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask, that is there, or you can put it into the chat and ask that way. I'll just take it through the last few slides that we have. Okay, so just to recap what all we have looked at. So how to extract the context from a user through a mini questionnaire. So we looked at the things like how physically you are, okay, what are your qualities in terms of your nature, okay. We try to put them in terms of words. We try to find out icons for that, symbols for that, and we try to kind of create a palette of those. We explored certain things. We selected few things from that, okay. So extracting these things, selecting, these were the explorations, then maybe selecting something from this, and then putting it together into a final expression. Okay, is the kind of entire process that we have looked at. Okay, again, going on to the slide, how to translate user insights into design tangibles. So the main question is, okay, if we have a snake over here, how it gets translated over here? Maybe the way I have done it, not that literally, it can be abstracted also, but these again will take you to certain very complex levels of design expressions. Okay, so here we definitely have used a very literal translation of this element over here. Okay, then also we looked at how to compose design elements into third dimension. So putting all these things together was a big challenge. Okay, so how these things would definitely look together. How to conceptualize and visualize your design idea. So putting these things together, we also looked at various concepts. Okay, and visualize them as the ideas, and definitely how to present your ideas. So again, without putting emphasis on to a very kind of a extensive kind of a sketching skills, still these kind of expressions can be conveyed to a third person, and that's what the use of drawing as a design tool is. Okay. Now, the last thing that we have over here, which definitely would like you to put into this template, or even if you are doing it onto a blank sheet, just write few lines about your expression. So the space over here maybe can be used, it can be put over here as well. So again, we are kind of looking at whether in terms of drawing, in terms of word, you are able to express your ideas or not. Okay, so that way also is what we looked at. Okay, now coming to the end to the workshop, definitely if you have any questions in that way, type it over there, we'll answer that. Okay, just to put a note, we'll appreciate the creativity. Okay, so whatever your work you will upload, we'll select best 5 entries from that. Okay, and that has to be uploaded till 3 p.m. today, and the link will be there on your screen, will be there on your Zoom chat as well, okay, or will be mailed to you as well. So right now it is on the screen, I can just show you that you can upload it through this link, your work, till 3 p.m. and we'll feature those kind of your expressions onto the MIT ID social media as well. Okay. Okay, so questions. Okay, so we have a question like, can we design our work for ourselves, or is there any certain things like some certain character? No, definitely not. You have to design it for yourself. Okay, so that's the challenge. So whether you understand yourself, I took one character because I'm not in front of you physically, you don't know me as a character. In terms of attributes, so I took one character, a fictional character, which I imagine that everybody will be at least, it's a known character, that's why. The second question is it compulsory to take all the items? Not that way, okay? That's also something that as a design aspirant, you should understand that where to stop, okay? So maybe I have extracted 15 elements, but my object, it's not needed that all 15 has to be there. Okay, so what to choose, what not to choose. So that is where your composition skills will come into place. There's also a question that, sir, I had a doubt regarding what tools do you use? Do you start thinking and connecting things with nature? Okay, so I'll take these as a separate questions. So what tools do you use? I think your thinking is the main tool that you have. Okay, so whatever you think is what makes you a design learner or a designer in that way, or makes you stand in this profession. The second important tool is you should be able to express your ideas. Okay, so most important is the drawing skills, which one learns. So definitely we don't expect when you arrive into any design institute that you are excellent with your drawing skills, not at all, because there is a different orientation that you go through and that is how you learn. And of course later on, yes, software and those kind of tools also can be used. So these are the tools that definitely are there. Do I relate it to nature? Yeah, definitely. Through art, through craft, most of the inspirations are from nature. And that's how, if you look at our traditional objects and many other objects also, definitely nature is the biggest tutor that we have. Okay, yeah. The next question, we'll try to give you individual feedback, definitely yes, okay, on your work in that way. So yeah, definitely I'll show the final sheet again. Okay, so this was the process that happened, these were the explorations, and this is where things have been put together. as an expression. I won't still use the word design. Yeah, you should, the question is, should we upload only our final design idea? Yes. So, even if you have done it on a separate sheet of paper, you have come up, conceptualize it to very level, take a standpoint. Whatever you think is your final design, that is the only thing that you need to upload. Is it compulsory to have good sketching skills? I would say good is a relative word. Okay, so you should have sketching skills wherein you are able to express your idea, that a person, the third person, should be able to understand what you have drawn. Up to that, definitely it has to be, and those will build up. So don't be very anxious about it that, okay, I don't have sketching skills. So entire design learning, you will be toned up in that way. Simplicity is better or complicated objects are better? It depends on what you want to portray your object as. So somewhere through certain philosophies, through certain context, that also will matter. Simplicity would be better. Somewhere you purposefully want to complicate things and you want to show that it is very complicated, there complexity would be better. But for this workshop, both are welcome. Both kind of approaches are welcome. Can we describe our chair or model in few words? Of course, yes. That was I was explaining at the last part of the workshop, that at the bottom of the sheet, anywhere where you will find this thing, just try to put it into very few words. Okay, so it's also ability as a design aspirant that one should learn into, that you should be able to express your ideas not only in terms of drawings but also in terms of words. So yes, it has to be, few lines has to be written about your own design. What if you are good but you want to design for evil and harsh? Can we do that? Of course, yes, you can do that. Okay, because you are portraying yourself as a king or a queen. So you can say that, okay, I am harsh and I am very evil for a certain time. Maybe something happens and then you change. So it's just a hypothetical question. So yeah, you can go for that. Not a real issue. How can we achieve a minimalistic approach when it always tends to get complex at the end? I think for that, 4 years of design learning also not enough. Okay, I would say we are also learning to be very minimalistic throughout our 20 years journey in design. Okay, but you learn it on the way, definitely, yes. But it's good that you are at least sensitized towards that. Very good. Do we need to show different views of the chair? If you are able to, absolutely well and good. But even one view which kind of explains the object in totality is fine. Okay. In the questionnaire, few qualities were given. So can we add some more qualities? Of course, you can. Okay. These were just kind of pointers that were there just to trigger your mind in that way. So you can have a list of many qualities as well. But again, you should know what to pick and what not to pick. Is the process of how to come to the final design of a chair as important as the final design? Yeah, process is important, and definitely at MIT Institute of Design, we believe our philosophy is only about giving importance to the process. Okay, so we believe that the final output evolves. If your process is very correct, very apt-ful, and your approach is right, you definitely will come up with a good final design. As an attribute, can we use other things, animal significance, like other objects? Yeah, you can use anything. Anything which kind of relates to that attribute, you can use that. You can use cultural icons, you can use animal abstractions. That's fine at this stage. It can even be cut and paste. We don't mind at this stage at all. Can we show a color scheme that can be used for our throne? Absolutely. So this is what bare minimum that it is. Okay. Ideally, these workshops are to be done in a stipulated time. So if you can express these qualities through a color palette, go ahead with it. We would welcome that. I haven't taken that part of the same, because it will become a separate workshop altogether. How color expresses qualities. Can we upload more than one picture for the concept and for the actual presentation? No, there has to be just one picture. You can put it, either it's a PDF file or it's a picture, but the size is restricted, okay? So just try to understand the logistic, okay? And it's also about taking a final standpoint that this is what my final expression is. You said you could include this project in the portfolio. So my question is, what does the college look for in the student portfolio? We have different kind of interviews or things on the web which talk about that. On our website also, we have a list of qualities that we look. This is what I'm talking for MIT Institute of Design from our point of view. So these are the kind of qualities that we look into design aspirants. Okay, so through this, what are we trying to portray? If we put it into portfolio, we are trying to show to the third person that yes, this is how I can express certain intangible elements as a tangible way onto an object. So that is the way it will go into the portfolio. Okay, so I think definitely we'll like to take more questions, but time is a constraint. So don't forget to leave your feedback on the Zoom chat over there, how you felt about this workshop, whether it was good, whether it was useful in that way. And hope we'll meet you again and again through these series of workshops which are going to be there. So just be in touch, be looking for these workshops. They will be there on our website, and there's a series of exciting workshops that are going to come for many next months that are over here. Okay, so for here right now, a very thank you for attending this workshop, and I think we'll end the session over here with this. Thanks once again.